Good evening, friends. Hello. My name is David Macbeth. I am the director of music here at First Presbyterian Church of Bethlehem. And I am the choral director at Lehigh Valley Charter High School for the Arts, and I direct their touring choir. And I am currently the interim director of Conchord Chamber Singers. So I'm wearing a lot of hats this evening, and from all three institutions, I bid you welcome. I'm so glad that you chose to join us tonight for a concert presented by our dear friend, Mr. Emmet Cahill. As our warm-up, you'll hear from two of the three choirs, and at the end, obviously, we'll be joined by all three. Touring Choir presents, to start things off for this evening, All Flesh is Grass by my friend, Chris Massa, and Morten Lauridsen's Sure on this Shining Night.
So grief all I find, and
And for your second warm-up, Conchord Chamber Singers offers Sunrise Carol by Dan Elder and Like a River in My Soul, arranged by Tom Osick. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, and now, the guy you've waited for, Emmet Cahill.
Folks,
that's loud.
Folks, that was just absolutely incredible. Let's give them a huge round of applause. It is always one of the wonders and the beauties of what we do that you get to come and meet people that are just simply transcendent in what they do, and both of those choirs, both the youth choir, which is absolutely magnificent, and then the two combined groups are just really, really special. And these are the moments that we savor on tour. We're kind of just sitting back there and you're kind of discussing what we're doing and going here, and then there's just this moment of calm. You go, right, just sit back here and listen to that, because it's just fantastic with their magnificent director, David. He needs a huge round of applause, that man. And don't worry, you'll hear more from them before the end of the evening. They'll be all back together just before we finish this evening. Without further ado, it's my great pleasure. This time last year was one of our first concerts back on the road in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, and we were very, very happy to be here. And we're back here again this year, and let's give a big Bethlehem welcome to Mr. Emmet Cahill.
Thank you.
Perfect.
Thank you very much. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you all this evening? Good? Great? I'm great too. It's great to be here. I was just thinking when I came out and sang the very first song there, I'm just aware that this mic wasn't on, and I was just thinking the first phrase in, I thought to myself, the mic's not on, but I am actually, aside from performing concerts and doing Irish music and sacred music, I am an aspiring opera singer as well, so I guess it's good practice, because they can't use mics. So when I work with my coaches in New York, you know, they say, you know, if you start performing in operas, you know, you may forget about those microphone things. They don't exist. And you just have to simply use the acoustics of the room. But I have to say, there is a wonderful acoustic in this beautiful sanctuary anyway, so we weren't too bad off. But thank you so much for a wonderful welcome. And as Seamus mentioned there, it's wonderful to have, now I don't know if this is the right phrase, but a wonderful support act, because I feel like I'm supporting these guys because they just sounded absolutely fantastic. So thank you for your beautiful singing, guys. We're it's always a joy to come back to Bethlehem and work with David and the choirs. And I grew up singing choir myself, so it's kind of deja vu for me when I hear all this beautiful choral music. But I'd love to continue on now with a song that I've been singing for many years, both touring with Celtic Thunder and by myself, and it's very significant to me because it, in many ways, tells the story of America. It tells the emigrant story. And I suppose I'm so aware from my years touring all around the States that one of the most remarkable, and I think one of the most wonderful things about the United States is the fact that it's a country of people from all over the world. Because many generations ago, your ancestors left their homeland, left all that they knew in far-reaching countries across the globe, and you came here to America to pursue opportunity, to pursue prosperity, to make something of themselves, but also to pass on that opportunity to their children and to the generations to follow. And ultimately, you all sitting here tonight are the benefactors of the opportunity that they were given, the hard work that they put in, their ability to overcome adversity. And that is very much America's story. So I'd like to sing a song for you now that tells the story of a young Irish girl by the name of Annie Moore, who in 1892, with nothing but a bag on her back and uncertainty before her, passed through customs at Ellis Island into New York and entered into the land of opportunity, the land of liberty. So this is Annie's story. In many ways, it's my story. It's your story as well. It's a song called Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears.
On the first day of January, 1892, they opened Ellis Island and they let the people through. And first to cross the threshold of the Isle of Hope and Tears was Annie Moore from Ireland, who was all of 15 years. Isle of hope, Isle of tears, Isle of freedom, Isle of fears, but it's not the isle you left behind. That Isle of hunger, Isle of pain, Isle you'll never see. But the Isle of Home is always on your mind. In a little bag she carried all her past and history, with her dreams for the future in the land of liberty. And courage is the passport when your old world disappears. But there's no future in the past when you're 15 years. Isle of hope, Isle of tears, Isle of freedom, Isle of fears. But it's not the isle you left behind. That Isle of hunger, Isle of pain, Isle you'll never see again. But the Isle of home is always on your mind. When they close down in a silent in 1943, 17 million people had come there for centuries. And in springtime when I came here and I stepped onto its piers, I thought of how it must have been when you're 15 years. Isle of freedom, Isle of fears, but it's not the isle you left behind. That Isle of hunger, Isle of pain, Isle you'll never see again, but the Isle of home is always on your mind. till you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. And I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me
Thank you so much. The beautiful Gounod setting of the Ave Maria. And I suppose for those of you who have been to my concerts before, you'll know a little bit about me, but for those of you who maybe just know me from being in Celtic Thunder, long before I was in Celtic Thunder, before I ever stepped foot on a stage, I was singing in church. And my dad was a church organist, my mom was a singer, and we used to go to church every Sunday to sing in the choir, so it's very much where I started. So I always love to bring the sacred music with me wherever I go. But indeed, I've had the great privilege of seeing so much of the world and bringing music with me wherever I go, and it's a wonderful way to travel and when you get to do what you love, but also to share music indeed with audiences and choirs and orchestras and various music ensembles. And over that time, I've, I suppose, learned so much, not only about America, but I've learned so much about Ireland. I am Irish, did I mention that? But we were chatting a little bit earlier in the meet and greet, some folks were asking me about little pockets of America that have Irish, I suppose, history or presence. But I know here in Pennsylvania, very much it's both Irish and German, are kind of two very, very present, I suppose cultures, and many of you, I'm sure, have Irish lineage and German lineage, and indeed probably from other countries as well. It's the fascinating thing about America, as I mentioned, it's a concoction of people from all over the world. But over that time, you know, people who emigrated and left everything they knew behind, what they had was their culture. Their culture was a huge part of their identity, from literature to poetry to songs, and it's lent, I suppose, the idea of emigration has lent itself to so much wonderful music. And I'd love to continue with another beautiful Irish song that tells the story of a man, or I suppose it's a man looking back on his life as he nears his end. And I suppose for so many years, for so many generations, once you left your homeland, you never got to return to see the places that you loved, to see the people that you once loved. And this man is reflecting on the fact that he will never see his home again, and indeed he will never see his beloved again. And he dreams of flying to Ireland, dreams of getting home to the place and the people that he loves. And he's from a place in Northern Ireland called Carrickfergus.
Passed on now. I've spent my days in endless roaming. Soft is the grass, my bed is free. To be home now in Carrickfergus on that long road down to the sea. It is reported there's marble stone there as black as ink, with gold and silver I would support her, but I'll sing no more now till I get a drink, for I'm drunk today. Sure, I'm seldom sober. A handsome rover from town to my days are numbered. Come on, ye young lads, and lay me down. Come on, ye young lads, and lay
so much. What a beautiful song that is. So I'm always very curious when I come back to a church or a community of faith or any town in America, and I've played a fair few towns at this stage over the years of touring. Actually, believe it or not, it's just gone over the precipice of 11 years of touring in the States for me. I did my first tour in September 2011. Ah, how the years flow by. The nights get darker. But yeah, 11 years. And I've seen quite a bit of the world in that time. As I've said, it's a joy to bring music with me wherever I go. But believe it or not, I have performed concerts in 48 states. Yeah, and I think all of the provinces in Canada as well. And Australia and Tasmania. Don't know if they've... Australia has states. I think Tasmania is a state. Anyway, I have two left. Any guesses as to which two I've left? Hawaii and Alaska. You're not supposed to know that, but yes. Yeah, so because some people say to me, really, you've been to, like, Idaho? I said, yeah. You've been to North Dakota? Yeah. I've been actually a few years ago with Celtic Thunder. We played I think it was a Celtic festival, but it was kind of Celtic but also kind of Scandinavian. It was called Norsk Fest. It was like a mix. Yeah, you're laughing. So we went to Minot. Minot, why not, right? You've been there. Yeah, you were stationed up there. That's where you hold all the ballistic missiles, isn't it? I think so. Only you can't tell me that. Okay. Security alert here. But yeah, we've been, and when you land in Minot, wasn't that the place we landed? There was Terminal 1 and there was Terminal...
Yes, there was gates 1 to 20.
Oh, there was gates 1 to 20, but there was only two gates. So Seamus's bags landed in gate 1. I'm like, oh, mine are in 20. Oh, no. Yeah, some of the... This is the kind of stuff we get a laugh out of, you know? When you tour so much, and particularly when you come back off the road after a long tour, people ask you, you know, what happened? Loads must have happened. You were in 75 cities in 4 months, and you kind of can't remember anything because it just goes by in a blur. Like, every day is Groundhog Day, but in a different state, right? So, and then when we go back to certain cities, like backstage in the theater starts to look the same after a while. So the way I usually remember this, I walk in, and then I walk into catering, and I was like, this is where we had the chicken. I remember what I ate in certain states, but after that, it's kind of, on a Celtic Thunder tour, it can all get a bit blurry after a while. Not blurry as in, just blurry. Where was I going with this story? Oh, yes. So I'm always curious when I come back to an area as to who's seen me before. So who's seen me in concert before? Get a show of hands. Ah, quite a few. Basically everybody. Great. Who's here for the very first time? Ah, okay. Yes, we have some newbies. So you're part of the clan now. There's no getting out. It's a lifetime membership. But for those of you who've been here before, you'll kind of know what's coming next. No, it's not the part where I dance. Don't worry. You don't want to see me dance. Actually, when people ask us about Celtic Thunder, you know, we're on PBS TV a lot, and people aren't sure what the show is. They say, oh, Celtic Thunder, are you guys like Riverdance? And I said, we're exactly like Riverdance, but no dancing. And less makeup and foundation than dresses. They just throw us up in a suit. But where was I going? Oh, yes. So, if you haven't been to my concert before, you'll like this section, because I hope you read the small print on your ticket, because I suppose the number one rule about coming to an Irish concert is that you have to sing. And I don't mean just our fabulous choir. These guys were working hard earlier, I've been working hard, but it's now time for everybody to work hard together. We're in a house of God, we are in a community of faith, churches are for singing in. So we're going to sing this next Irish song together. But before we have our grand performance of said song, we are going to have a rehearsal. David told me I had to rehearse with you before. Now, don't expect me to bring you to the level that David would, but let's have a little rehearsal now.
Tooralooralooral.
That was okay. But we have two of the best choirs my ears have ever heard in the room. We have a wonderful congregation. I believe in you. I think you can do better than that. We do it one more time with a bit more gusto, and you can sway if you want.
Tooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooralooraloo An Irish lullaby. many years ago, me mother sang a song to me in tones so sweet and low. Just a simple little ditty in her good old Irish way, and I'd give the world if she could sing that song to me this day. And I hear her voice a-humming to me as in days of yore, when she used to rock me fast asleep outside the cabin door.
Song every time I come on tour, because every time I go back to Ireland, my mother asks me, how did you get on tour? And I say, yeah, very well, yeah, yeah. Did they all, you know, did they give you a good round of applause? And I said, yeah, it's fine, yeah, yeah. She says, and then the last thing she asked me is, did you sing my favorite song for them? And I say, yes, mother, of course I did.
We're after the same rainbow's end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend, Moon River.
There is no fear.
sometimes in life there are things that you hold very dear to you, and for me, music is one of them. Singing wonderful music is something I feel very privileged and honored to do, to pursue my passion and my love. And there are certain songs that hold a very, very dear place in your heart. And this is one that I can never leave out. It's one that I carry with me wherever I am in the world, from my hometown in Mullingar in Ireland to Bethlehem, Pennsylvania here tonight. It's the song of all Irish songs. about this guy on the piano, Mr. Seamus Brett. And now, for something completely different. In Ireland, we call this a sharp turn left, no indicator. But I just love this song. And I love Italian people and Italian food, so why not?
Che bella cosa una giornata e sole, un'aria serena dopo una tempesta, per l'aria fresca. Che bella cosa una giornata e sole, ma nel sole più bello in me, o sole mio.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Emmet Cahill.
Thank you, folks. Thank you. So, we're not finished quite yet, because one of the stipulations I had for agreeing to come back to Bethlehem, Pennsylvania this year was that I got to sing with these wonderful choirs. So, I would like to welcome back a wonderful Charter Arts Choir from Lehigh Valley and the wonderful Conchord Chamber Singers. So, as you can see, there's quite a contingent of singers here tonight, which is fantastic. And I talked to David about bringing them on tour, but he kind of said you might need a bigger tour bus than the one you have. So as I said, singing with choirs, it's been one of the most enjoyable aspects of what we get to do touring and working with other musicians and singers and learning indeed from other singers and musicians and being exposed to new repertoire, because there's a great affinity within the realms of sacred music, and particularly within the Christian communities, there's a great connection with music. Like, I know from coming from a Catholic background, coming into whether it's Methodist churches or other denominations, the one thing that's absolutely uniform is the music. So it's wonderful to collaborate in that way. And you also get to discover new music. And we're going to finish with a beautiful Irish blessing. But before that, I insisted that we do this one. It's one of my favorite Latin hymns by Mr. Cesar Frank. And one of the first hymns I ever performed myself in church. It's the beautiful Panis Angelicus. And I think we have Seamus on organ there. We have an organist. You playing this one, Seamus? Obviously, he took the night off early. Thank you. So folks, this will be our final piece of the evening. Just on behalf of myself and Seamus, I want to say a huge thanks to you all for coming out here this evening, to all the guys on video and sound, to everyone here at First Presbyterian for allowing us to perform in this beautiful sanctuary once again. Can we give a massive hand both to the Charter Arts Choir from Lehigh Valley and the Conchord Chamber Singers. Thank you so much, guys. And the biggest hand of the night to a man who has not only become, a compatriot of mine, but a great friend over the years, Mr. David Macbeth. Thank you so much. It's a joy to work with David and to see someone so passionate and enthusiastic, not only about choral music, but about young people, about people performing this music, both with the Conchord Chamber Singers, with the Charter Arts, with all the other choirs that he works with. The sense of community that you have here, and it's a wonderful thing to be part of a choir, to be part of this wonderful music ensemble, and this guy is so diligent going about his business. And he's the reason why we get this wonderful chorus of sound. His attention to detail is just fantastic. So David, we so appreciate you and all your incredible work. So we're going to leave you tonight with a beautiful setting of the Irish Blessing by Philip Sopford. So thank you so much, and we'll see you all again very, very soon. Good night to you.
May the sun Mr. David Macbeth and our wonderful choirs.